So next is Yamal Damian Mehmood. Did I say it right?
Correct.
Okay. And I'm going to touch this, hoping it doesn't fail us. So you are this one, right? So I had you in capital.
Right. Okay, hello, good afternoon. My name is Yamal Mehmood, and I work at the Translational Immune Oncology Lab in the Institute of Biology and Experimental Medicine in Buenos Aires, Argentina. I have recently completed my bachelor's degree in biotechnology, and I am now beginning with my PhD project. In our lab, we work with melanoma. Melanoma is the deadliest form of skin cancer and has a melanocytic origin. And the main risk factors are family history, genetic ancestry, and exposure to UV radiation. And the 80% of cases are curable by chirurgical resection. And in the case of late diagnosis, the 20% of the cases are in metastatic stage with an average survival of 6 to 9 months and a survival greater than 5 months, but 5 years of 5 to 10%. In the last year, they have appeared new therapies in melanoma. On one side, we have targeted therapies. Targeted therapies are designed to block specific proteins in melanoma. For example, is the case of BRAF inhibitors. BRAF is a protein of the MAP kinase pathway. This pathway led to cell proliferation and tumor growth. By the other hand, we have immunotherapies. Immunotherapies are designed to block with antibodies immunological checkpoints, for example, CTLA-4 or PD-1. These checkpoints are used by the tumors to escape of the immune system. Okay. The problem is that almost all cases in melanoma treated with targeted therapies become resistant. And in the cases of immunotherapies, almost about 50% of cases don't respond to the therapy. So the goal of our lab is to find biomarkers of response to these treatments. Our lab is especially interested in galactin-1. Galactin-1 is a lectin that recognizes glycans on the cell surface. The structure of these glycans is regulated by enzymes called glycosyl transferases and glycosidases. And galactin-1 has been demonstrated in at least 10 cancer types that has an effect immunosuppressive. And we also are studying the role of the inflammasome in cancer. We are in a collaboration with the Pasteur Institute of Montevideo, Uruguay. The inflammasome are multiprotein complexes whose biological function is to induce inflammation. Also, the inflammasome activation generates the activation of natural killer and CD8 T cells. Well, for this study, we use public databases. We used Cancer Genome Atlas, the Human Protein Atlas, and the gene expression Omnius. We also use a method called CyberSort to infer or to estimate the composition of the immune infiltrate in tumors. This method has a gene expression signature matrix. By default, the matrix is LM22, that the differentiate 22 immune cell types. And it results in the relative proportion of each cell type or an absolute score. The absolute score is calculated normalizing with against the total expression of the biopsy. We are using a package called MIXA. MIXA is developed by Rodriguez et al. from the Bioscience Data Mining Group, and the MixUp package allows to perform a massive and integrative GeneSeq analysis over several experiments and GeneSeqs simultaneously. It uses singular enrichment analysis, GeneSeq enrichment analysis, and we can use microarray or RNA-seq data for this analysis. Okay, first, we study the role of the galactin-1 in cancer, and we study the expression of galactin-1 across different cancer types in the Cancer Genome Atlas. We found that melanoma is the cancer type with the highest expression levels of galactin-1. Then we compare the expression of galactin-1 in tumors against the expression in normal tissues from the Human Protein Atlas. We studied the expression in melanoma, breast cancer, colorectal cancer, and lung cancer. And we found that in tumors, the expression of galactin-1 is overexpressed in comparison with the normal tissues. Also, we performed a survival analysis of melanoma patients with data from the TCGA. We found that the patient with the highest expression levels of galactin-1 have a poor survival in comparison with the patient with the lowest galactin-1 expression. Then we perform an analysis of mechanisms of response and resistance to immunotherapies. For that, we used two data sets from Shio. The first is a cohort of patients treated with anti-PD-1 pembrolizumab, and it has biopsies before treatment. And the other cohort has biopsies before and during treatment, and the immunotherapy is anti-PD-1 with nivolumab. In the first case, we performed a differential expression analysis of galactin-1 and glycosyl transferases between patient responders and non-responders to anti-PD-1. We found that responders present higher expression levels of 3 cyclin transferases in the tumor biopsies and lower mean expressions of galactin-1. Then we studied the inflammasome pathways. For that, we used the second cohort, the Rias et al. We found that a responder shows an activation of the inflammasome pathways during treatment and could be used as a novel biomarker and therapeutic target. In the first graph, we have responders versus no responders in biopsies taken during treatment, and in the second plot, we have a paired analysis of responders pre-treatment versus on-treatment. Then we did an analysis of the immune infiltrate with CyberSort, and we found that responders present an increase of the relative fraction of effector cells, a decrease of immunosuppressive population during treatment. We also found that the total infiltrate increased during treatment on responders, and again, an increase of CD4 memory activated and T cells CD8. These changes in non-responders, this not happen. This didn't happen. And then we perform an immune profile of these responders versus non-responders, and we found that patients who did not respond to anti-PD-1 therapy present an immune suppressive infiltrate in the tumoral biopsy taken before treatment, and the same in the biopsies taken on treatment, with an immune suppressive infiltrate in patients who did not respond. Then we analyzed the mechanisms of resistance to targeted therapies. First, we performed a differential expression analysis between biopsies taken during treatment and on treatment. Pre-treatment and during treatment, and we found that it was observed a decrease on the expression of genes related to cell cycle, cell division, and proliferation during treatment. And when we analyzed the progress biopsies versus on-treatment biopsies, in resistance, the differences found during treatment seems reverted, and it is observed an increase on the expression of genes related with cell cycle division and proliferation. And when we compared pretreatment versus progression, we didn't find any gene differential expressed. So here we used the MIXA package, and we performed with MIXA a meta-analysis of pair samples of four cohorts of melanoma patients treated with BRAF/MEK inhibitors. And we found 49 gene sets altered across all data sets, and a group of genes that are mostly contributing to the gene set enrichment in pretreatment versus post-treatment analysis. Then we did a SHIO tree, and the SHIO tree allows to evaluate the depth of the terms found, and we could identify biological process deregulated across all data sets. For example, the regulation of cysteine type endopeptidase activity involved in apoptotic process. When we analyzed the immune infiltrate, we found that macrophages M2 are increased in progression or in resistance. Macrophages M2 are related with immune suppression. The same for neutrophils. So, as conclusions, we demonstrated the importance of using bioinformatics tools and public databases to do meta-analysis of large cohorts of melanoma patients. We characterized the immune cell populations that are modulated during response and resistance to targeted therapies and immunotherapies of melanoma patients using CyberSort and transcriptomic data. Also, we demonstrate that inflammasome pathway genes are activated during treatment with anti-PD-1 in patients who responded to the therapy and could be used as biomarkers as potential therapeutic targets in melanoma resistant to immunotherapy. We demonstrate that galectin-1 is a protein overexpressed at transcriptomic levels in melanoma cells, and we postulate that it could be a mechanism of cross-resistance to immunotherapies. Using MIXA, we could identify biological function deregulated across different data sets that could not be detected by classical differential expression analysis. Our next steps are increase the sample size by adding new studies with publicly available data, validate the molecular signatures found in this work in other cancer types, develop keystone signature matrices for use with cyber. So in particular, we are working with the exhausted CD8 T cell profile. CD8 exhausted are associated with immune suppression. We are conducting in vivo studies in mice to test the therapeutic effect of anti-galectin-1 antibodies in conjunction with anti-PD-1 therapy. We also want to analyze the influence of the mutational load and the presence of neoantigens in the response to treatment and the relationship with UV radiation and the composition of the immune infiltrate. Biological validation of the results obtained in this study in melanoma models in vivo and in vitro in the laboratory. And the development and application of new bioinformatics tools based on algorithms for the study of altered biological functions in patients' biopsies, focused on an iterative approach in collaboration with the Bioscience Data Mining Group of Dr. Elmer Fernandez. Well, this is the members of my lab, of our lab. This is the Translational Immuno-Oncology Lab. I would like to thank to Harry Lloyd Foundation. Okay, this is a foundation of melanoma, and the National Institute of Cancer from Argentina. I would like to thanks also to the organizers for rewarding me with a travel grant. Thank you very much. Thank you.